Hi guys, welcome to NetGate Chemistry. So in coordination chemistry, we are now going to start with the topic of John Teller distortions. So before starting with the topic of John Teller distortion, we need to study about the electronically degenerate states and the distortions in the complexes. What are distortions in the complexes? So first we are going to discuss about the electronically degenerate states. Now the first question is, what are electronically degenerate states? So whenever there is a set of orbitals which is unsymmetrically filled, right? When we have set of orbitals which is unsymmetrically filled, then it is going to form electronically degenerate states. So what do I mean by saying this is that, suppose we have these 5 d orbitals, right, and we have d1 configuration in some sort of a complex. Suppose we have d1 configuration, so it will be like this. Okay, this is before splitting. Now before splitting, if this is the configuration, then where are the possibilities in which this electron can reside? So this electron can reside in one of any these 5 orbitals. So these are, suppose dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square and dz square. So out of these 5 orbitals, because all these 5 orbitals are in electronically degenerate state, so what happens, energetically degenerate state, so what happens, electron can occupy any of these orbitals. Okay, so all these 5 states which you can see in which electron is occupying different orbital, all these 5 states are known as 5 electronically degenerate states. So what I have said earlier is, if we have a set of orbitals just like this, this set of 5 orbitals which is unsymmetrically filled. See, the filling of electron is unsymmetrical. There is only one electron present here, right? So there is unsymmetrical sort of a filling. So electron can occupy more than one positions, more than one orbitals, and the number of possible occupancies of this electron, these all 5 states in which electron is present in different orbital, these are known as the 5 electronically degenerate states, and this state is highly unstable. Okay, as you can see, the state is not stable at all. On the other hand, if I have a set of p orbitals, okay, px, py and pz, and we have p3 configuration somewhere, now you understand what are the unsymmetrically filled orbitals and what are the electronically degenerate states. So basically what you have to remember is that whenever you are going to see a set of unsymmetrically filled orbitals, then you should remember that they are going to undergo splitting. Why? So that they could release some energy and gain stability in their configuration. So what happens whenever they undergo splitting, it is also going to undergo distortions, right? Initially this was undisturbed, this set of orbitals was left undisturbed, and whenever the splitting happens, there is a release of energy giving stabilization to the overall complex, that we will be calling as John Teller stabilization energy. After the splitting, the overall molecule is going to get distorted, right? So this we will study in detail afterwards, but before that we need to know about distortion. We need to have a little bit idea about what are distortions. So suppose if we have a degenerate states, which we have studied here also. Okay, this is about the electronically degenerate states. What are electronically degenerate states and why electronically degenerate states are not at all stable? What is the reason for the instability and how they undergo stability, right? Via distortions in the molecule. So one thing is for sure, that distortion is going to cause stabilization in the overall complex, and these distortions could be because of the metal also and could be because of the ligand also. So that we have discussed what are distortions, right? So now with this, with the general knowledge of these two concepts, we will move on to the John Teller distortions. What are actually the John Teller distortions? So the next topic is actually John Teller distortion. So now, starting with the topic of John Teller distortion. So whenever we are going to have a non-linear molecule, this is a very important point. We are discussing the cases of non-linear molecules. Whenever we are having non-linear molecules which are having electronically degenerate states, that is why we have studied what are electronically degenerate states. So first we have to look in the molecule, that is whether the molecule is linear or non-linear. John Teller distortion occurs only in non-linear molecules in which we have electronically degenerate states. As we know, these states are unstable one. So their electronical degeneracy, their electronic degeneracy needs to be removed for stability. They require to be removed for stability of the overall complex. And when we are going to remove the degeneracy, the electronical degeneracy of the set of orbitals which are electronically degenerate, then what happens? It leads to the overall distortion in the molecule. Right, it lead to the distortion in the molecule, and these distortion causes the lowering in overall symmetry of the molecule. Now these distortions which we are going to absorb because of the removal of electronic degeneracy, these type of distortions are known as John Taylor distortions. Overall, you can call it sort of a John Taylor theorem also. What John Taylor theorem says, John Taylor theorem basically tells about the John Taylor distortions. So what are John Taylor distortions? First, we have to look for nonlinear molecule. In case of nonlinear molecules, whenever we are going to encounter electronical degenerate states which are unstable one, these electronic degeneracy needs to be removed so that the overall complexes stabilized. So in order to remove that electronical degeneracy, what happens? Distortions takes place. Whenever degeneracy is removed, distortions takes place. So what happens? Because of distortions, symmetry is lowered. We have discussed the octahedral case, right, just a few minutes before. So due to distortion, symmetry is lowered. And these types of distortions which we are observing, these are known as John Taylor distortions. Okay, so overall distortions, they are going to increase the thermodynamic stability of the molecule, and this is going to be the driving force for the John Taylor distortion. This stability is the reason for the distortions to take place. John Taylor distortion happens to provide overall stability to the molecule. So this stability is the driving force. So this is a little bit about the John Taylor distortions. So in the next video, we are going to continue with the John Taylor distortion in case of octahedral complexes. That is very important topic. From there, we will discuss the types of John Taylor distortion, that is Z out, Z in, and triaxial distortions. So I think so far that's it for this video. In the next video, we'll continue with John Taylor distortions. So far that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching.